السلام على أشرف الأنبياء المرسلين سيدنا ومولانا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. On this blessed day of Eid, this Mubarak day of Eid, we celebrate the festivities. We celebrate with our families and our children. We celebrate by giving them salam. We celebrate by giving them the Eidi. We celebrate by giving them their gifts. We celebrate them by making this a happy day for them. We meet one another. We visit one another. And we forgive one another. The greatest thing that we do on this day is we forgive one another. We can do it right here as we are sitting here. If somebody has wronged us, if somebody has done something to upset us, today, yesterday, a week ago, a month ago, or 10 years ago, 20 years ago, clean your heart and say, "Oh Allah, I have forgiven them." Make your intention with me, brothers and sisters. Say, "Oh Allah, I have forgiven them for your sake. Oh Allah, we are taught that those who forgive for your sake, oh Allah, you are the most merciful one. Oh Allah, your haya, your modesty, your ghayra comes into practice and says, they forgive for the sake of Allah, I forgive all of their sins." Forgive one another for the sake of Allah on this day. And make takbir. Make takbir of Allah and the dhikr of Allah. After this Salat al-Eid, we have Dhuhr left. We must pray Dhuhr. We must pray Asr. Brothers and sisters, let it not be that the Eid festivities distract us from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Sisters in particular, I have a message to you. I know you are looking very beautiful today. I know you have purchased clothes today and you want to look good. Alhamdulillah, this is a ni'mah of Allah. And you do so for your families. This is a blessing and a ni'mah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And continue to do so. But let not your food, let not your jewelry, let not your clothes distract you from the worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Let it not distract you from Fajr, Dhuhr, Asr, Maghrib, Isha. This celebration has been mandated by Allah. And it can only be a blessing when we remain connected to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Pray our prayers, brothers. Do not put too much burden on your sisters. Do not make Eid difficult for them. Let it not be an Eid in which they stay in the kitchen from morning till evening. Bring your sisters for Salatul Eid. Bring your daughters for Salatul Eid. Bring your sisters and your mothers for Salatul Jum'ah through this holiday period and give them the opportunity to go through a tarbiyah, inshaAllah. Sisters, pray your salah punctually at home on time. It is a great reward for you. Sisters, fulfill the rights of your children and your husband and you will gain nearness to Allah. Your staying at home and taking care of your family is a jihad. Your jihad is striving within the home and you are rewarded for this. My sisters, I plead with you. We are all a bit stubborn, but sisters, Allah has blessed you with having the soft hearts. Allah has blessed you with being Rahim and being beneficent and merciful. I request you that maybe when there is an argument in the house between the husband and the wife, between a couple of people, I request you to humble yourself and be the one who lowers themselves for the sake of Allah. Not lowers themselves because you are wrong. Not lowers themselves because you are not dignified, but lowers herself because she is glorious in the eyes of Allah. And to my brothers sitting here today, the women that you have in your life, if they are your daughters, they are amana from Allah. He says that those who bring up their daughters and give them tarbiyah and have married them off in the best of ways, in the Islamic ways, I give them Jannah. And those of us who marry our wives, they are amana from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. A woman is always a trust from Allah, whether in her mother's house and her father's house, whether in her husband's house or whether in her brother's house, in every shape and form, Allah has taught us that these women belong to me. They are my trust and I have handed them over to you for a short time. Fear Allah in regards to your women. Fear Allah in regards to your women. Do not oppress them. Do not make them waste excessive time in cooking. Do not hold back their nafqa and their expenditure that they are deserved of, for fulfilling the commands of Allah is an obedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Rabbana atina fid dunya hasana wa fil akhirati hasana wa qina adhaban nar. Oh Allah, give us the goodness of this world and the goodness of the akhirah and save us from the punishment of the grave. Rabbana la tuzigh qulubana ba'da idh hadaytana wa hab lana min ladunka rahma innaka antal wahhab. Oh Allah, do not deviate our hearts after you have guided us. And oh Allah, la tuzigh qulubana wa hab lana min ladunka rahma, and grant us mercy from yourselves. You are the bestower of mercy. Oh Allah, we ask that you do not leave any sin of ours today except that you have overlooked it. Ameen. And any sick amongst us today except that you have cured them. Ameen ya rabbal alameen. And any diseased except that you have forgiven them. Ameen. And any debt except that you allow us to repay it. Ameen. And O Allah, do not leave for us any anxiety or stress or any grief that you have healed them and cured them on this day, Ya Rabbal Alameen. O Allah, we ask you to lift from us this plague and this disease. O Allah, we ask you to lift from us this plague and this disease. And O Allah, bless us with a life of comfort and ease. You are the Qawiyu and the Aziz. O Allah, of this dunya we ask you of the best. And on the day of judgment we ask that we pass the test. And in the akhirah we wish to be from amongst the blessed, Ya Rabbul Alameen. O Allah, bless Islam and its people. O Allah, bless Islam and its people. O Allah, the Ummah, make it safe and peaceful. O Allah, the Ummah, make it safe and peaceful. O Allah, the Ummah, make it safe and peaceful. And protect it from all those who strive for against it for evil, Ya Rabbul Alameen. You are the Rahman and the Rahim. You are the Mawla. And we have no Mawla other than you, Ya Rabbul Alameen. Servants of Allah, know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has commanded you with the command that He began with Himself, and then He followed it up with the angels themselves, and then He asked us to follow it ourselves. For He says in the Holy Quran, إِنَّ اللَّهُ مَلَائِكَتُهُ يُسَلُّونَ عَلَى النَّبِيِّ يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا صَلُّوا عَلَيْهِ وَسَلِّمُوا تَسْلِيمًا. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. Oh Allah, make this day a blessed day for us. Oh Allah, all the people around the world who are celebrating on Eid al-Adha. Oh Allah, wipe away our sins and make this day a means of our hidayah and our guidance. Ameen Ya Rabbal Alameen. And oh Allah, make it a day in which we gain your nearness and save us from indulging in that which displeases you. Ameen, Ameen, Ameen. Birahmatika Ya Rahman Rahimeen. Wa Eidukum Sa'id wa Mubarak. Jazakum Allahu Khairan wa Ahsan al-Jaza. Eid Mubarak to everyone. May Allah accept taqabbal Allahu minna wa minkum.